So let's see if we could do something just a little bit different. The issue on the table. Patients with submassive pulmonary embolism, do we thrombolize with highly toxic agents or support with other therapies? Remember, this decision affects lives. I'm not here to tell you what to do, just to give you the evidence so that you can decide. When your patient's on death's door with massive PE, with over 50% obstruction of their pulmonary arteries and hemodynamic instability, we've got this one, sussed. Clot bust. But what about when the thrombus isn't that big, but at least one of the following exists? RV dilatation on echo or CT, ECG changes or elevated BNP, evidence of myocardial necrosis defined as we'd expect by that famous brick body. That's right, my friends, no need for a phone-in, it's high sensitivity troponin. These submassive clots are more tricky, the doctor's divided about their therapy, but don't worry, no need for you to guess, very soon you'll know whether the treatment's best. Goddamn mind if you think treating a condition local to the lungs should involve thinning all of the blood, reducing clotting, risking major bleeding, not least around the brain. All the evidence would tell us simply no mortality benefit, and even if there was, the contraindications mean very few patients would ever get it. But that in itself is not enough. You've come to SMAC seeking more information. We'll go into the evidence more deeply so you can treat submassive PE. There's plenty of papers and plenty of evidence. Surely the answer lies somewhere within them. But before we get on to that, let's just consider it historically. Every condition we've treated with lysis has either been superseded or disputed. Infarctions, both myocardial and cerebral, once thrombolized, it's now irrefutable. This treatment is practically medieval, yet here we are, still considering it suitable. Surely we must learn from our past and not use a treatment that should be outcast. I really do like the one they call Swami, but on this subject, I think he's balmy. Let's talk about facts, not opinion, then I'm sure you'll agree. I'm winning. It is so nice, it is so nice to have evidence on my side. It is so nice, it is so nice to have evidence on my side. Let us start by looking at a paper published recently, a registry trial conducted retrospectively. 16,000 patients with objectively confirmed PE. They looked for an association between lysis and mortality. The results they found, well, the results, they won't surprise you. More patients died from this toxic therapy. But friends, this is just the beginning of this rather complicated story. Let's move on to consider a well-performed RCT. In 2002, some 100 were enrolled to MAPIT3, a double-blind trial of thrombolysis versus usual therapy. The primary endpoint was in hospital mortality. And again, no difference was seen between lysis and normality. It is so nice, it is so nice to have evidence on my side. It is so nice to have evidence on my side. We've got all this evidence, but recent and old. It is so nice, it is so nice to have evidence on my side. Let's move on and consider some more recent evidence. This time a trial published in the New England Journal of Medicine. Over 1,000 patients recruited across Europe and based in France. The results seem positive, but it's key to further analyse. A reduction in mortality, yes, that's correct. But bleeding increased to a greater extent. It's industry funded, composite endpoints, you have to consider the results, are they valid? The evidence all seems to agree. Thrombolysis reduction on me. We have to move on to treatments more prevalent than clot busting agents causing life threatening hemorrhage. Submassive PE. It is so nice, it is so nice. Think of your patients and do the right thing. It is so nice, It is so nice to be here at Smack and sing. Here ends my argument, I hope you concur. It is so nice, it is so nice to have evidence on my side.